Yo, 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 we's back. And by we's, I mean CPA Strength and my DCA Adler Click. You know what it is. You know what's up. Yeah, we's back. I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. I educate, motivate, and inspire people all over the world by teaching them accounting, building block by building block by building block. If this is your first time here, hi, welcome aboard. If you've been binging for a week, what up? If you've been following for a couple years, bless ya. Anyways, before we get into this great video, this is an awesome video, by the way. They're all awesome, by the way. Before we get into this one, we're gonna show you over here by tapping on this card. This is the best playlist in the entire world. This has all of up to 70 in the playlist as you're seeing this now. So if you want all your dreams to come true, if you want companionship, if you want the best food calorically free, hit that over here. If you want to be juicy, if you want to be a demigod, go over there, hit that thing, come on. This is number 70. This is my classic series. It's the classics, boy. Why? Because it's like the first series. They're gonna be like, CPA Strength was, that was his classic series. He's gonna do his 1,000th video. You can't believe it. This is Breakeven Point. Yeah. Oh, I don't know what Breakeven Point means. Chill, dog, just chill, okay? Because we're gonna do all the Breakeven. Now, this is actually like a real life video. What do you sell at your business? How many of those do you have to sell to break even? How many of those do you have to sell to make some money? So this is Breakeven Point. It's very important. I just love it. I was always like, what's the Breakeven Point? Or, you know, how much do I have to make? Or this or that. Or I just love it. Also, we're gonna break it down a little, you know, a little like how I think about it, because you can just Google search this, you know, or you're YouTubing it, but anyway, I'm gonna go how I think about it. And I think some, you know, tends to get overcomplicated. Some people tend to overcomplicate things. The Breakeven Point, let's just get into it, okay? What the Breakeven Point is, okay, how many, Breakeven Point is, how do I break even? When do my revenues equal my costs? That's the Breakeven Point. You know, I'm selling widgets. We're selling tax returns here. You know, that's what makes sense to me. What makes sense that you could sell? You know, what have you sold in the past? Just, it could be anything. You don't even have to tell anybody, you know? Doesn't have to be legal, doesn't have to be illegal, doesn't have to be real. This is great, it's imaginative. Who says accountants aren't fun and don't have imaginatives, right? I'm very imaginative. Doesn't have imaginatives. What the fwark, dog? Yeah! Kiddo! So at the very least, revenues equal your costs. That's what break even is, you know? I sell a tax return for $200, or I sell a widget for $200, whatever it might be. I have costs associated with selling this tax return or this widget, right? And that's what business is. That's why every business is around, except maybe a nonprofit, except the people in nonprofits make money, but let's get past that, right? The nonprofit didn't make any money, but the guy working at the nonprofit made $1 million. Okay. Okay, that seems legit AF, right? You're in it to make money. How do you make money? That's what you got coming in versus what you got going out, right? In versus out. So your sales is what's coming in. Your cost is what's going out. So we want to find out when coming in, coming out equals. Like how many items do I have to sell before, you know, I break even? So I got to do that so I'm not losing money. Revenues equal costs. Think about that. Just think about that. You can have kind of a like an algebraic term. I mean, if it's easy for you, you can solve for this, you know, doing algebra or whatever. But this, because there's Like, I couldn't do calculus. I failed calculus, I think, 3 times. Like, I barely passed business calculus or algebra. I just don't like letters and the numbers. It just, I just don't understand it. But if this is you, like, if this is you, then you solve for this. If you get the break even, because now we're just basically extrapolating the revenues equal cost to get the break even point. Revenues in purple over here, $200 sales, right? Per, it matters how many per tax return or per widget. So when we get our break even point in units, right? Which, you know, we can plug it in to our algebraic expression later on. That's what I would do. I would plug it back into this to see if it was correct or not. That's $200 times how many units is our revenues equals our costs, right? Revenues equal cost for break even. I think that's so self-explanatory, right? If it's even, whatever's on this side equals this side, that's even. Break even, because we're gonna break even, all right? I hope that's standard. So what are our costs? Well, our fixed are 600, so that's never gonna change depending on how many units we sell or we don't. But the variable costs do matter how many units we sell or don't sell. So that's why there's an X right here for the variable, because it's $50 for variable and $600 for fixed. So there's our revenues equal costs. There's, it's kind of out in algebraic expression, but it's $200 times how many units, that's our sales, equals $50 variable cost times how many units we sell plus $600 in fixed costs. The how you get the break-even point, what is the break-even point? It's fixed costs over the contribution margin. Right, now that's what the break-even point is. So if you get, you know, you got a question on a test or whatever, what's the break-even point? You've got to have been doing enough of these. It should say fixed costs over a contribution margin. That's the break-even point. You know, that's another way of doing it. You don't know what that is. You can have fixed costs over sales minus variable costs. You know, you can have that next to DC Adler on your sheet. If you did that, fixed costs over contribution margin, and what is the contribution? See, I'm just gonna think about it logically, really. I don't really even know this formula for the break-even point. I would just figure it out, I guess, intuitively. Because, oh, I did have a break-even point for my business when I opened it up. I'm like, how much tax returns do I have to sell? How much bookkeeping do I have to do? How much payroll do I have to do to keep the doors open? But if you use this, I'm lost. I don't even know what to call it. The formula for break-even point. Fixed cost over contribution margin, and contribution margin is sales minus variable cost. So break-even point is fixed costs over sales minus variable costs. And let's think about why that's important and let's just look at this. The sales, the variable, and the fixed for a second, okay? Now, and this is what I always do. I always kind of break it down into something small where I can see, and the formula will work for these numbers as well as millions and the off numbers that you can't conceptualize in your head. Break-even point. You might forget the formula, but anyways, you're gonna say, how do I break even? Well, I sell a tax return for $200, but it costs me $50 in tax software to do it. So I make $150 profit per tax return that I sell. All right. And see, that takes care of my variable costs in it. And that's why the contribution margin is so nice, because it takes care of these X's and the algebraic form. So anyways, I have If I sell one tax return, I'm gonna make $150 off that tax return. Yeah. And per tax return, I make $150. Now, what do I have to cover? I have to cover the $600 in fixed costs. So I need to sell four of those to break even. That makes sense? Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, great. You know, that makes sense. So that's, so what did you just figure out here? You just figured out $150 profit, right? And you just divided that into $600 to get four units. What was the $600? Fixed. What was the $150 contribution margin? Well, that's, you know, what is contribution margin? The sales minus variable costs. So we just kind of did it in our head so we'd know the formula. So if you get break-even point and you can't remember anything, on your test or whatever, just do a sales price, a variable cost and a fixed cost with really small numbers, so you can conceptualize it in your head, like this, how we just did it in our head. I think it was very easy. Yeah, you need to sell four of these, man, to break even. Duh, right? So then you say, well, how did we get that? I guess it's called reverse engineering. You got to go in reverse here. How did we get that? Now, we have four units. Is that going to work? Is that for real? That's why I love this break even, because you can just plug it in. If we sell four units, is our revenues going to equal our costs? I don't know. Let's go back to the algebraic expression. So let's take out this X and put in four. Because I can rock with this, because now we don't have freaking letters in our math, right? Jeez and crowbars. Four, right? We sold four units. That's $200 a pop times four. That's $800. That's going to equal $50. $50 in variable costs per pop times four. That's $200. Plus the $600 in fixed, that's $800. $800 equals $800. Ding, ding, ding. Four units is our winner. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Let's stay positive, people. Let's stay positive. And that was break even. What is break even? Revenues equal costs. Okay. Anyways. Gotta stay positive, gotta stay away from the haters, right? Evade the haters. Call me Ray Charles, because I don't see the haters, right? I only see haters when I'm looking in my rear view, and trust me, I don't look in the rear view too much, because I'll wreck out, okay? I'll crash if I keep on looking in the rear view. So I'm trying to say, I don't even feel them haters. I don't care about them. Guess what? Because they're gonna hate regardless, all right? And they've been hating on me since I've been 2 years old, It's all been hate, bro. It's all been hate. Until I didn't care about the hate, and I started going on YouTube and not caring, and then I started getting so much love. So who even knows? This is a crazy world, right? Living la vida loca. Ooh.